My bad. I'm going to talk about last week and this week's episode. So we're going to start with last week's episode first. Okay, so all the girls go out and they're at the club, and the little dirty looking one with the red hair, what is her name? The little dirty looking one with the red hair. Whatever. Okay, Sydney. Sydney. She finds a guy there that she likes, or I don't even know about life. Somebody she just want to give her vagina to. And he has, like, you see the earrings in my ear? He has these inside his earlobe and tattoos all over his face. And yeah, I borrowed the scallywag thing from, was it Nikki, the bitch with the rankers in the forehead? I think that's who I borrowed it from. But anyway, she ends up leaving when she leaves the club, inviting him over to the bad girl's mansion, and he brings his little handicapped friend with him, I guess for a decoration. And yeah, he was lame. And so then after that, the handicapped friend leaves, and she invites the dude with the tattoos on his face to spend the night, because she says she gets what she wants. And usually, okay, this is the thing, she invited him to spend the night because she say she get what she want. Okay, I don't know, this bitch is delusional. One, then the reason why I say that is because when he left, she told everybody she sucked his dick. So I didn't know. I'm a little confused with this. And the reason why I say this is because she says she kept him overnight because she gets what she wants. Maybe she wanted vitamin C-U-M. Because, you know, maybe she wanted it because, you know, the nutrients for her skin. Maybe that's what she wants. Because usually when people get what they want, they're not on their knees. You know what I mean? Little dirty little girl. Yeah, when they get what they want, they're usually not on their knees. Okay, so anyway, like I said, she was in the kitchen telling the girls how she sucked them off and stuff. Real classy, real classy. And that's what happened then. Okay, moving on. We'll get back to that. The girls go out again. That's how you know they weren't really doing shit, because how many times the girl went out, how many nights they went out and shit like that, like, they weren't doing shit. Like, these motherfuckers had to film, like, a whole week to get this week's show. I know they did. Because it's like they were going out, then they were going out again, and then they were going out again. I didn't even fucking know how to follow the show. I really didn't even know how to follow the show. I was just like, damn, what? I can't follow the show. What's the main idea, bitch? I need a subject. I need a... shit, they should have had a plan. I could not... It was very... It was a fucking gumbo show. That's what it was. A whole bunch of shit they just threw together. But anyway, the girls go out again. And basically, Nikki calls some dude annoying that's trying to talk to her. The bitch ought to appreciate it because, you know, maybe he's into trannies. But anyway, the refrigerator body looking bitch. But anyway, she calls him annoying and shit like that because she's a lesbian. It's not a fact yet. But anyway, Kentucky goes off on somebody at the place, and then they get kicked out. I don't know. I kind of like Kentucky. I like her because I just think she old country, barefooted ass, crazy bitch, and I like her. I don't know. She just like she might be a fucking cheerleader, with some fat back hanging out the side of her mouth and barefooted, running through cow shit. I don't know. I just like her. She country as hell and she crazy. So I think she gonna give us a little something. But she ain't that damn crazy because what happened the next week. Okay, but I get into that because I gotta hurry up. When they get home, Nikki says she has beer muscles and shit like that. She's talking about Kentucky because Kentucky was showing out on a girl at the place, and somebody else get on it. What's that damn girl name? The girl we'll forget before the show end. That's gonna be her damn name. The girl we gonna forget before the show end. It's gonna be her name. It was Nikki and the girl we gonna forget before the show end. The girl we gonna forget before the show end called Kentucky hillbilly white trash. Hillbilly white trash. And her voice is a little extra for me. She sounds Werbin, and what I mean by Werbin is white urban. So yeah, Werbin, that's my nice way of saying she sounds Werbin, white urban. Okay, so we're moving on. Then Kentucky, you know, mush Nikki ass in the face. Yes, I was so glad Kentucky mushed Nikki ass. We're gonna call her Wiki or Wiccan, or the bitch a witch. We're gonna call her Witchy. Or I don't know what to call that bitch, Nikki, but anyway. Oh, I know what to call her. Bitch with the wrinkles in the forehead. Okay, so then Kentucky called her mama and told her mama what happened. And mama on the phone talking shit, like straight heel bitchy on the ass. Like, for real, mama go straight heel bitchy. And mama all on the phone. Mama gangster. I like mama too. And mama on the phone co-signing and shit on Nikki's future ass whooping. And you know, I just love the fact that Kentucky mushed her in the face. Didn't that feel good? That didn't feel good to you guys? Like, it just really, it made me feel a little tingle inside. I just, you know, I just like that. I wish Jay would have done that, but you know what, that's alright. You know, so, you know, mama all on the phone gangsta and shit. Mama co-signing Nikki ass whooping, bitch. And I approve the fucking loan. Whoop her ass. Mama co-signed the ass whooping. I approve the fucking loan. I want that ass to be whooped. I don't know these bitches. I don't know about that green jolly green giant. That bitch. Okay, King Kong body. Okay, whatever. And so anyway, Lauren, please just whoop her ass. Okay. So then they go out again, and Sydney's her man shows up, and because she's delusional as hell, that's really her BFF. That's her BFF. Yeah, they BFFs. They best friends fucking. That's what that mean. That's what BFF mean. Best friends fucking. She's delusional. That ain't her man. You know, she one of them type of hoes that screw 10 niggas and think she got 10 men. When really she just got 10 niggas that screw with her. That's Nikki. She, not Nikki, not the big bitch with the rank on the forehead, but that's the little dirty one. That's the dirty one. We're gonna have to come up a name, instead of Super Red, like Superhead. Yeah, Super Red. Okay, so Super Red. Anyway, then they at the club. Okay, then the girls go to the club. Back to the club. They leave the club, and Char already pissed at the bitch, with the wrinkles in her forehead, and, aka Nikki. And then they go to get in the limo, and then Barbie, lets Char know she got her purse, and then Nikki knocks, Char's purse out of Barbie's hand, and cuts, Barbie's hand, and then, so Barbara goes to the hospital and get one stitch, one. And these bitches, they act like she lost her damn arm. This bitch get one stitch in her finger, and they act like she lost her arm. And like she on life support and shit from blood loss. But you know what? Okay. And then, you know, whatever. I've injured my hand worse from beating the hell out of bitch. I mean, for real, she crying and shit and carrying on. Okay, they some punks. They some punks. Ugh. Then, Barbie, a punk with spunk, cause she showed her ass, but you know, when she got back, she wanna punch the wall and shit. She almost, you know, got another stitch put in there from that bullshit. Okay, so Nikki ugh ass, yeah, ugh, like the boot. The bitch look like, her bitch look like a boot. She look like the ugh boot. all in her face. You know what? She looked like the Ugg boot, and her face looked kicked. Okay, but we moving on. She told Sydney boyfriend that Sydney sucked somebody dick before he came, and it was true, but it wasn't none of that bitch business. It wasn't none of her business. And then Sydney all telling her BFF, her you know, they BFF's best friends fucking. She all telling him, you know, it's not true, blah 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 blah. And then to me, I don't think he really give a damn. Long as you suck his while he there, I really don't think he care. You know, he just wasn't concerned enough to me. He just didn't seem irritated or mad enough to me. I don't think he gave a damn. You know. You know, long as you ain't on his clock, you know what I mean? So, that's, you know, long as she ain't sucking dick on his clock, I don't think he gave it. And he didn't seem like he cared. So, Nikki, is a self-proclaimed prankster. And, you know, that's what she claims. She gonna be hiding folks' shit and shit. And I don't even know why I brought that up. Okay, and then they all, well, anyway, fast forward. They all had a sit down, and, Sydney go off on her because she told her BFF that you know, she gave a dude the professional, a stranger the professional. I mean, he gonna know anyway, Sydney. You got mad at her for telling something you already damn told on national TV. He gonna know anyway. It's either he gonna see the show or maybe the herpes will appear first. I mean, come on, bitch. Okay, but anyway. They all, you know, having a sit down, and they telling this bitch, you know, with the wrinkles in her forehead, that she gotta go. That bitch sitting there, boy, you hear crickets and all type of shit, boy. I tell you, the show was over and everything. That bitch ain't budged, she ain't moved nowhere. Matter of fact, next show came on, that bitch still was there. So anyway, everybody started yelling and shit, and she had some of her shit on the show, mattress, and you know, that's so last season, Nikki. Get find something else to do, bitch. Okay? Find something else to do, Nikki, Nicholas. Find something else to do. Who did that last season? That's so fucking Christian. That's what it is. Christian did that shit to Brandy. That's so last season, bitch. You know what? Whatever. Okay. Lane. Well, her dump truck by the ass. But whatever. Moving on. Nikki still don't leave, okay, and the girls, they go out and, leave Nikki again. So, Nikki go out by herself, this time, while they was out, actually say something, okay, I don't went too far, because I was supposed to go into, season two or whatever, but, anyway, Nikki still won't leave. So the new girl get down and everybody gone. Okay. Okay. And then the funny thing about it, as soon as they get home, Char sees the new girl's pic. This is the thing to me. Bitch. Why you hating soon as you come in the damn house? Bitch, you hating before you take off your shoes. So, the girls go out and shit, and then they get back, and, everybody's like, she's pretty, and then Shark, I'm like, ew, she ain't pretty, and this and that. You hating like hell. You know what, Shark, you do think, the new girl's pretty. You think Ashley's pretty. You do think she's pretty, and that's what bothers you. That's why you felt the need to hate immediately. Okay? Your little hater, buzzer just went off, hate, real, real hate.